I'm back. Hello everybody on YouTube land, Jamie Powell back for another mail unboxing, I guess if you will, special delivery. And one of these I can't show because they're actually birthday presents from my friend. So yeah, that might be a little awkward. First one that I'm opening is this one. It's from USNA. Now this is what I think it is. Yeah, it is. And you know why I know this is because you have that, and then you got this inner packaging. This is from an eBayer, Carmen something like that. And he's a fantastic eBayer. He has all these new movies that come out, and they're at a reasonable price for free worldwide posting. So yes, he's very good at wrapping his films. And very descriptive. I mean, he was the one who sent me Underwater Blu-ray. And I managed to get that at a very good price. It sold out very quickly because it was at a very good price. Now it goes for stupid money. So, see what I mean? He just really, really goes to town with the wrapping. I mean, he should sell still bits. He does better wrapping than bloody Zavi do. It's not hard though, is it? We're getting there. Oh, we're getting there. We are there, in fact. Ready for this? Ta-da! Guns Akimbo with Daniel Radcliffe. And it also stars, I can't see a name here because I haven't opened it properly, but this comes with a slip as well. Guns Akimbo is about a guy, Daniel Radcliffe, who's a bit of a troll on the internet, especially for like this game that's going around where people, it's like a sort of fight to the death sort of thing. And it's the go out of Ready or Not, Hugo Weaving's daughter, I believe. So yeah, and I've been really wanting to see this.
Someone's trying to kill me! Please, go drive now!
I'm Miles, and this is the story of the worst day of my life.
Another schism
picked random psychos, weirdos, and criminals and made them fight each other to the death. So the internet loved it. And then I came into the picture.
You scared yet? Welcome to Schism.
And it's got good reviews and the trailer is mad, and I love me some mad trailer. So can we get onto this one? Guns Akimbo is the first delivery then from this little lot. So very pleased to pick this up. Again, it was cheap and it came with a slip, which is usually quite hard to come by when you order stuff from America. It's very 50-50, so very glad to have picked that one up. In fact, we're going to do this one next. This is from HMV, and I'm pretty sure I know what this is. And if you've seen the thumbnail to this, which you would have done because you clicked on it, you probably can guess what it is by the theme that I tried to do for this particular video, because I had a feeling it would be this one. Oh yes, baby. In one. And it is. Thank God, because I made the thumbnail before I made the video thinking it'd be this. And that is, of course, the HMV E First Edition. Is it E? E? I don't know. But it's the Lighthouse.
Tell me, what's a timberman want with being a wiki?
Just looking to earn a living. It's like any man. Starting new.
On the run.
Now, when this first came out, I did do a review for it on my channel, and I wasn't too sure.
Thank you.
So, The Lighthouse, starring Willem Dafoe and Robert Pattinson, is a story about these two people who work at a lighthouse. And it's shot in black and white, it's square format, and it's a very well-polished, well-acted, well-directed, well-written movie. I think it's a very unique experience, something which you don't see too often. It's a very rare find. It is a brilliant movie, but it just... it didn't do nothing for me. I thought it was very good though, and I can see why people, some love it and some hate it. It's one of those, either people are going to stay and watch it or walk out. I stayed to the end because I was curious to see what happens, but it's basically two guys work hard, get drunk, see weird shit, and on repeat. Two guys work hard, get drunk, and see weird shit. And as the film progresses, it gets more weirder, they get more drunk. And it's got some good ideas, like I said. It's very well polished. It's a good movie. It just didn't tick the box for me. So critically, it's about 4.5 stars. Personally, I go 3.25. Good, but just not something I'd watch again.
I don't know. There's something about this movie which it kind of stayed with me for weeks after. And I kept thinking about it, and it kept playing on my mind, and I thought, I actually want to give it another go. Because, believe it or not, The Babadook, which is one of my all-time favourite horror movies... First time I saw it at the cinema, I thought, I'm not too sure about this. And then the second time I saw it, I fell in love with it, because it wasn't what I thought it was going to be. And it was much more than I thought it was going to be. And it certainly is a film you have to think about, and it stays with you. And it's the same with this one. I think this one stayed with me a lot more than I thought it would. My first initial reaction was, it's okay. But I really want to watch it again, and I'm going to do a re-review of this. And if anybody on the YouTube world wants to do a collaboration, it can be as many as possible. We'll all do our own review, and then we'll upload the review at the same time. And we'll just mention each other as a sort of friendly, collaborational thing. So yeah, The Lighthouse... I'm not going to unbox it because it's already been done by Big Porty. Go and check him out. Go and subscribe to his channel. He is awesome. And I will leave a link in the description for Big Porty's unboxing of this Blu-ray. So the next one then. This one has come from Spain. I know what this is, obviously. And it's a film which means a lot to me. My mum and I watched this one night late on television. On Channel 4. We were about to go to bed, you know, it was getting quite late. And it came on telly, and we started watching it, and we were hooked from the world go. And it was just a little moment. Me and Mum stayed up to watch this one night. And it's a fantastic 80s gem. Let's get into this. Now, like I said, this is a Spanish import, so it's going to have foreign writing all over it. But, my dear friend Richard, if you're watching, you know I'll be giving you a message shortly. And of course, it is... The Lady in White.
It's 1962. It's Halloween.
I wish I was as weird as you.
Thanks.
There's nothing wrong with the town of Willow Point Falls. But a powerful imagination can't cure.
London Bridge crumpled under the monster's huge lizard feet. That's impossible. Or is it?
But this time, it's not make-believe.
No, don't hurt her.
It was too...
It does have an English dub without any subtitles, you know, on the screen. This is the film which I watched as a kid. Alice is about a boy who witnesses something, and it's like a supernatural drama. It's quite scary in places, but it's a very heartwarming story as well, and I really do recommend this. The USA have released this, but it's around about £50. I got this for about £13, about £12.80, something like that. And a bit of a bargain, really, because now it goes up to about £16-17, I guess. But I'm going to do an unboxing quickly, because I don't think many people will know about this movie and would have this movie either, because it is quite a hard-to-come-by film. So I'm going to do an unboxing. There we go, then. So, I've managed to open it. That is the back cover. There we go. So that's it. There we go. And that is my delivery for today. Hurrah! Hope you've enjoyed it. Please like, share and subscribe. I will see you again soon for more videos. It's going to be work for the next couple of days, but expect some more videos, hopefully up on Sunday and Monday. And next week HMV is reopening, people, and in Bournemouth and Pooley Pooley Pooley. But we won't be going to Pooley 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 because it's too far to go to Pooley Pooley Pooley. So we'll be actually just going to Bournemouth and not Pooley Pooley Pooley. Oh my God.
Shut up.
Right, I'll see you guys soon. Take care. Please stay safe and all the best from me. Take care and thanks for subscribing. Got 570 now. And we've got this giveaway coming up soon as well. Don't forget there's a giveaway coming up at the end of this month, 30th of June, which is me and the wife's wedding anniversary. And if we get to 600 by the 30th of June, I will be adding a few more titles for the giveaway prizes. So more prizes and more chances for you guys to win. Again, I also will leave a link down to that video down below so you can so you can go and enter that competition, because £20 voucher is not to be sniffed at, people. Well, I hope not. And and another thing, I've decided that when I hit 666 subscribers, which you know is the devil's number, I will do a horror movie giveaway. That's right, I'll get some horror movies and we'll do a giveaway. So when I get the 666, because it's quite a random number, but it's appropriate for the horror giveaway, so there'll be some titles up for grabs then as well. But let's focus on 600 and then get to 666. Of course, the big goal is 1,000. That ain't gonna happen. You never know. God, do I go on or what? All right, guys. See you soon. Bye for now.